Happy release day to us.
Happy release day to us.
I know,
the song is out. I'm so hype. I've been listening to this song like in my notes app on my phone for like years. Like, I'm so excited that this is actually gonna see the light of day. People are gonna get to hear this stuff.
I'm in the same boat, and I was actually reflecting. I don't think I told you last time we talked. This is obviously like, I love the song, but this is big for me because I realized your record, Everything, is I think it's the first record I ever cried to.
No way.
Yeah, that when the female vocal comes in on that last song, and like, you just like, I remember I had this distinct memory of, I was living in Melbourne. It was like, I think it was like 2017. I got on late.
Yep. Sounds about right.
And like, I was like riding my bike around, ironically, riding my bike around and listening to City Bike, and then I listened to the record and like got to the end. It was just like, but what if everything's not everything? What if I was wrong? So thank you. Thanks great. For that.
Yo, thank you, man. I mean, that was a very emotional project for me too. I love hearing when it's like actually translated and people have felt the same thing. And especially that ending though, like when Astrid comes in on the end, like with the little moment, I love that moment. That's like top three moments in the whole album for me.
I agree. And I think for me at the time, like I was making a lot of beats and I was like, I'm an instrumental producer. Like, how can I convey a long form story over a whole record? And I think that was like a really big learning experience for me of like, oh, this is how you do it. Like, you can, you know, you don't have to sing every song, even though I've kind of ended up elsewhere, but it was a good lesson.
I was going to say, like, cause you're a full on singer at this point. Like, I'm hyped to hear the rest of this project and everything too. Like, I'm assuming the project is not far behind.
The
right?
project is done. This whole thing has been done for a long time. It's been mastered for like a year.
Bet. Well, hey, everything was also mastered for almost a year before it came out.
What made you wait?
In my situation, it was kind of like circumstances, like a lot of other projects that I was working on at the time that just like took focus that I was like, I have to do this right. Also just like, you know, label stuff and, you know, the usual things. What about you? What's the reason that you waited this long?
I think it was like somewhat similar in the sense we wanted to find the right home for it, but also I guess this wasn't a reason why we waited, but this is a reason I'm glad we waited. And it's that I don't know if I was like emotionally prepared, and now I feel like quite emotionally prepared. And I actually really like, I don't know if you had this experience, but because it's been done for so long, now I'm listening to it more as a consumer and I'm not so inside it because I had a break from it.
100%.
Yeah.
100%.
And it's kind of nice.
I can imagine. It's like, it's emotional music, so like getting a little bit of distance from it is probably healthy.
Yeah, and I think a common phrase in Australia is tall poppy syndrome. Have you heard of tall poppy syndrome?
No.
It's a thing in like Britain and Australia, and it's basically like, I would call it a social epidemic of like, it's like frowned upon to be proud of yourself, or frowned upon to be different, or frowned upon to be the tall poppy, essentially.
We have the same concept in Norway,
right?
I think it stems from like an old children's book or something like that, with like a well-intentioned, like we it's called the Law of Yonte,
okay,
which is like a law that just like a list of rules that says like, you're not supposed to think you're better than anyone else. You're not supposed to make anyone feel like they are less than you. Like, you're not, like a bunch of things that kind of like are end up like resulting in the same phenomenon that you're
talking
about.
Yeah. Cause I don't disagree with those sentiments. I think they're valuable.
Right.
But I think like my experience with that, with the record, is like, because I've had so long away from it, I don't feel shy to be like, oh, this music's great. Like, I'm proud of it. It's like, because I feel detached from it. So,
right. 100%. I mean, you should be proud of it. This song is absolutely beautiful.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Do you want to maybe like tell me a little bit about like how this song started in the first place? Because I kind of came into it like halfway through the process. Like, how did this song get sparked in the first place?
It was so random. Okay, so I even the preamble is random. I was living in a decommissioned nursing home in the UK by myself.
Okay. Wow.
And then I was in the UK and COVID started, so I packed up and left. Like, I booked a flight and like it was like all dramatic. I was like on my laptop, I was like, I need to be on the next flight out. And I like went to the airport and came to Australia. And I was staying, I had to quarantine for 2 weeks. So my partner's parents have a house in this little beach town. And I was just, I don't know what happened, but I decided that I'd give singing a go. Cause like previous to this, I hadn't really sung too much. Like, I was really self-conscious about my voice, and I just started making music from a place of like not having preconceived ideas and not using like my fingers. I find it really interesting to, because I play keys and I play instruments, I think like playing with sound and playing with audio files is much more interesting to me. So I was watching this Instagram live of, do you know Blake Mills?
Yeah.
I was watching Blake Mills. Oh my God, so good. I was watching Blake Mills and I was just like, fuck it, I'll record this. So I took the dongle out of my iPhone and plugged into my interface and like sampled a bit of him playing, and then was like, this is very beautiful, let's make something out of it. So I fucked with it a bit. And it just kind of led me to these chords. Like, it was like, it wasn't what he played, but when I moved, like when I pitched the chords around, it just made this like cyclical thing. And I was like, oh fuck, this feels great. And then
Sick. This
was, I don't know, I assume you might've had this experience, but I don't, like, it was one of those songs where it just like fell out. Like, I didn't think, I wasn't like, what am I trying to say? I was just kind of like, these are the words. These are the syllables that feel right. And this is the melody that feels right. And this is like a weird, like the form is just kind of like A, B, A, B, A, B. And I was like, fuck it. It feels like the right thing. And I think the 3-part harmony thing that's going the whole time, I think that stemmed from me being insecure about my voice. So I was like, fuck it, I'll like use my brain and harmonize it and make it, you know.
Yep.
And it just, it just fell out.
I mean, that's what it feels like. It feels like a very like natural conversation of a song. Like, it kind of just like, and that's part of like why I fell in love with it in the first place too. It's just, it felt different. It didn't feel like, you know, I get sent a lot of music because that's how this song happened in the first place, right? Like,
yeah, you were doing live streams.
Right. Because it was like literally what, the first couple weeks of lockdown probably. And like everybody was like, oh, like we gotta be live streaming. Like that's the thing. So I was doing like a couple live streams and I did like a send me demos type of situation. And you sent me the song and I was like, what is this like, this is very different than everything else that I've been sent like in the past couple weeks. And I think part of it was like, it felt like such a like natural flow of ideas and not like, you know, I think we as producers and musicians very often try to flex very hard and like be like, this is a crazy idea, I'm gonna make it so crazy that it's so crazy. And yours just felt like a feeling, and I was like, oh, I really love this feeling. And you had like almost the whole thing like locked in already, and I was just like, oh, I see a little spot. Do you mind if I fit in right here? And to be honest, it was like a crazy moment for me too, because I had just gone through a breakup like right before lockdown, like literally within weeks of lockdown. So I was like in like a really like emotional, vulnerable place as well. And then like that song just like landed in my inbox. And I was like, this is exactly what I need to get some stuff off my chest. Like, wow. Thank you so much.
That's so nice to hear that it was like, it came to you at a time that maybe you needed it, or like it was, you know, it spoke
perfect
to you.
Time. It was raining outside crazy. Like, it was locked down for the first time. Like, we all didn't know if the world was ending or like, I had just like, you know, split with this girl. I was like, is the world going to end before I see her again? Like,
yeah, wow.
It was just like a lot of emotions at the same time. I love the way that this song came out.
Me too. I loved the song and I was like, yes, I love this section of silence, this section where we can just chill. And I was actually, you know, like, you know, the feeling of like being protective over your art. You're just like, and I remember the first time I heard it, I was like, okay, I really need to like detach from this because I need to like live with this. And now over time, I'm like, oh no, actually what you did is fucking perfect, because as well, like I was originally also concerned because like your vocal sounded so fucking good and I was like, oh no, this is so like, it's so like this. And then it's just such a refreshing moment and such a like, I think from what I hear of like what you did to this song, you approached it in a similar way of like listening to the song to find out what it needs rather than like flexing or doing like, it just felt like you didn't have necessarily preconceived things that you needed to prove on this song or things you needed to say.
Right.
Like you listened to what was going on. And I think it's like,
100%.
I mean, a testament to you as a producer and a writer. Like, I think you did a great job. You approached it. I
appreciate that a lot, man. I really, really appreciate that. And it was really, you're absolutely right. Like, for me, it was kind of just like trying to have a conversation with, because when you sent it to me, it already had like the saxophone, like beautiful saxophone solo happening in the background. And all those like peaks and valleys were kind of already there. So like, I really felt like I was having a conversation with the saxophone when I was writing.
Fuck,
it was like,
yes.
Like all of my decision making was kind of informed by that, where I was like, ooh, like they need to hear this, and then I can come in right here, and then like, ooh, and this means that I go over there. It was like a dance kind
of.
Wow.
Yeah.
And I like, and I totally feel you. Like the when I was recording it too, I was like, oh, I'm doing this like way too hi-fi. Like, this is so nice and like dusty and lo-fi. Like, I was like, why am I recording this in such like a crispy way? But I really fell in love with it.
Yeah.
Like the contrast with some new frequencies that you hadn't thought about for a while coming in at that point feels like, I don't know. I really, really like it.
I also really, really like it. Like, it's so refreshing because you've been put in this dusty world and then it's like, oh, here's sparkly newness. And then it does. Oh, and then it goes to the shit you did, the production you did, like those chords.
Oh, yeah.
It's so good. It's so good because, like, at least for me, like as a Lido fan, it's so Lido, and I'm like, yes, this is it. It's like a little moment and we get it, and then we go back to the end. And I think also the end where you made the choice to sing with me, I think that was such a great choice.
Okay, sick.
Yeah.
Okay, fire. I wasn't sure if I was like intruding in that pocket because I was like, you have such a nice little world built. Like, I was like, do I even mess with it?
No, because I feel like if you didn't do that, we would go to future land and then we'd enter back. We'd go backwards. Whereas because you're there, we move forward into future and past land.
Right, right.
Yeah,
100%.
So,
dude, I'm so excited, man. Like, I really love this song. This has been like a very special song, like, you know, like I said in my notes app for a couple years.
I mean, that's really meaningful for me. I don't know if you've seen the video yet. Have you seen the
video? I haven't. Okay. Wait, there's a video?
Let me send you this. Have
what?
Watch it right now. It is.
I will watch it literally right now.
It's fucking insane. So this girl, Jackie, who did all the art on the record, this is her first ever animation.
Here we go.
What are we love. Oh, I think that I'll speak to my friends. If it's just to be entertained till the bitter end, then I wish that I loved myself like I did then. But I don't, 'cause I live in pretend.
Oh, this is beautiful.
I can't sleep 'cause my head's in a mess, and I need a little time to adjust to the creaks and the cracks in this world. We're supposed to think we're not enough. If I could, I would speak to my mother. Cause she'd tell me to look into love one another. I wish that I loved myself like I did then. But I don't, 'cause I live in pretend.
Zoom, zoom, I've been looking for Xenon. Have you seen her? We made a mess that we should really clean up for the rerun. She been the type of blessing I would dream of. Wake up exhausted, I need her. Said I don't sound like a Peter, but I put this dress on my damsel. I'm playing chess with my landlord. I never guessed I should dance more. I never guessed I should dance more.
I know, right?
What just happened? I wasn't even remotely ready for that. What, who made this video?
Jackie is fucking phenomenal.
Shout out to Jackie.
Shout out to
this
Jackie.
This is wild.
Mm.
Like, I have to watch this like four more times before I really know what to say about it. But like, this is so musically made, you know. Yeah. What I mean, like,
and I gave so many... I gave her no direction. I said interpret it how you'd like.
Wow,
dude, Jackie's plugged in.
She's plugged in, like, she picked up on some nuances for sure.
Mm-hmm.
Like, and like some of the things that like happen, like along with the guitar rhythm. Mm-hmm. And like oh man. Yeah, yeah, the zoom zoom. Oh man,
it's beautiful.
This is incredible.
And I think
what
we originally wanted it to be like a lyric video, and then she put the lyrics on it. I was like, nah, take the lyrics out. Like, doesn't need that. All it needs is the story is really about the detours.
And yeah, that moment is cool. That moment is really cool.
I think that's a fucking profound lyric. It's great. Like, yeah.
I'm sure I've stolen it from somewhere sometime, but like, but yeah, it felt profound to me in the moment.
No, it feels great.
Oh man, what a cool video, man.
Yeah, it's
like that was really inspiring.
I think the feeling I get with this song is like, it's just bigger than anything, like in the sense that like the song itself is an entity. Like, I didn't write this song, and like right. it seems to like with everyone who's been involved in the song and the video, like even the mix, like Nathan said this, he did the least to this song, and it's just like, mm-hmm. It has its own spirit and it's its own thing.
Yes.
And we've just like touched it, but like it's
100%. We've definitely channeled something on this that like we're like not in control over. I feel like
this is, and that's
how you make music that feels natural. You know what I mean? It's like letting go of that and just like trusting the spirit of a song. Like, because we could have. There's a lot of overthinking that I feel like could have happened on this song, and I'm extremely grateful that it didn't.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, me too. I think the spirit of the song was strong enough to say, chill. You guys are good.
We're good.
Yeah.
100%.
What was your experience like? I know you mentioned that you went through a breakup just before. Like, what was writing this and recording it like for you?
It was interesting. It was like a very vivid moment. I remember like it was lockdown had just happened. Me and my friend Jack was like working together, and he was at my house every day for like 2 weeks. I don't think I barely saw anybody else, and we were just locked in there, just making music and getting by. I remember it like raining really crazy for those first like 2 weeks in LA, like of lockdown. So like we were kind of like, oh, like, well, now we don't feel so bad about being inside. But like I remember like pouring rain. I set up all of my gear in my living room, and I had like every synth, every like drum machine, every controller, everything was set up. And I was just looking for inspiration, and then that just kind of like came in at the perfect moment, and I was like, well, I don't need any of these things that I just brought into my living room at all. Let me just calm down, sit down, and actually just sing. And it's not super often, to be honest, that I feel compelled to like write and sing in that way. It's like pretty rare that like pieces of music will make me want to do that. But this one was just like instant. So I was also in a phase at that time where I was like just really discovering and understanding writing while recording. This was fully like I recorded the first line and then I didn't know what was going to happen next.
Yes.
And then I just kept recording. Like, so it was really recorded chronologically without me knowing where it was going to go or what the context was or the storyline or anything. I just kind of started talking. And ever since that, like I've really loved like the stream of consciousness way of like writing music, where you're kind of like, you start at the beginning of the story and then just see where the story takes you instead of trying to create some crazy plot.
Yeah. That,
like you're supposed to puzzle together in a amazing like way somehow. So yeah, I remember it being like super emotional. I remember Jack just kind of being like, what just happened? Like sitting on the couch. It was the perfect rainy day for like that mood too. And I had like a lot of things that I felt like were not necessarily, I don't know. I kind of just like took the feeling that the things that you said gave me and just like applied that to my own storyline.
Yeah.
So I wasn't like trying to like fit perfectly into your topic or whatever. Yeah. I was like, all right, how can I expand upon this?
Yeah.
Kind of just talked about what was on my mind.
I think honestly that's perfect. I have a confession. When you were when you sent me the email being like, hey, so like what's this song about? I was like, fuck, I don't know. And I just like I was like, these are just words. I have no idea. And I made up that I was like, yeah, it's aliens coming to Earth, you know.
Yeah.
But I like went to my partner, I was like, hey, Lito just emailed me asking me what this song I don't know what it's about is about, and I don't know what to do.
let's make something up.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
So I'm glad it worked out the way it did. I'm glad you kind of, I mean, it's just kind of like echoing the spirit of the song told us what to do.
Yes.
Yeah.
100%. 100%.
Wow.
No, I love it, man. I'm really very happy that like people are gonna like hear this. Like I've played it for a few of my friends. And like, this is one of the ones that they like steady. I get like texts being like, hey, that one song, like, is that ever going to come out?
Yeah. Wow.
So I'm very excited that it is.
I'm super excited as well. I have a couple more questions for you.
What questions? Yeah, sure. What? Okay. Up?
Well, firstly, what's the last thing you've learned?
The last thing I learned?
Yeah.
Right now I'm trying to learn the six diminished scale, the Barry Harris.
Okay. Like, cool. Technique.
That's been like the big like, let me actually learn what this is.
Amazing.
I learned a word the other, because I'm Norwegian, so like English is still like something I'm discovering slowly. I learned a word the other day, ubiquitous.
Yes, banger word.
Banger word.
Yeah,
like great word. You sound so cool.
You sound cool. Well, it depends that when you say it, but yeah,
very true. If you, yeah, I guess you could use it wrong and it's not so cool anymore.
Yeah.
But I think ubiquitous is, I learned that word on like Saturday or Sunday. Mm-hmm. So I think that's like the last thing I can remember that I'm like, boom, I learned that.
That's fucking sick. Good answer.
What about you?
It's the last thing I learned. You know what? I watched Stutz yesterday, the Jonah Hill movie.
Incredible.
Mm-hmm. And I've been using... Incredible. Have you? You've watched it?
Yeah.
That moment where he's like, think of four things that you're grateful for and bathe in the gratefulness. And then the fifth time, don't think of a thing, just let the feeling come up. And yesterday, yep. I've been going to... Actually, I mean, this is... I guess... I wonder if... Do they do this in Norway? I've been doing sauna cold shower recently.
Oh, yes.
Oh, my God.
Big Norway, yeah. Energy.
Yeah, sure. I've been doing that like three times a week. And yesterday, I went... I had a weird day. And I went at night. And I, like, did the cold shower. And then I stood... It's in this, like... It's called a leisure center. It's like a... It's like a public pool type situation with, like, a sauna... And I was just like, okay, standing in the middle of this complex. There's like kids swimming in the pool. And I was just like dripping from the cold shower. And I just thought of the four things. And the fifth thing came up. And I like let the gratefulness bathe over me. And I was like, fuck, I can see rainbows. This is great.
Yeah. Yes.
So yeah, I've been, that's the last thing I learned that's been really useful in my life. For sure.
I love that. Wow. Absolutely love that. I don't. Is it a movie? Is it a documentary? Is it? I don't know what it is.
I think that's the right thing to say about it.
Right? Like it's beautiful. Like
it is beautiful.
I definitely. This is one of the ones where I was just like, oh, I'm texting this to like 10 of my friends right now. Like,
and
you need to see this. You need to see this.
The moment at the end where he's just like, I love you. I'm like, oh, I love you too, Phil.
Yep.
Yeah.
100%.
Okay. The next question. Well, the last question. When I say feelings worth living for, what comes up for you?
Feelings worth living for. I saw like a video recently that I thought was really cool, and I'm not gonna be able to communicate this perfectly back the way that she did, but like there was this woman that was talking about just perspective on life, I guess. Mm-hmm. And she was saying like, what if, like, imagine like you started out as an energy, you started out as like a little spark, of floating energy.
Mm-hmm.
And then God was like, hey, there's this place, it's called Earth. Do you want to go there for just like a second? Just pull up for like literally a blip.
Mm-hmm.
And in that blip, I'm gonna let you experience every emotion on the spectrum that you possibly could imagine. Do you want to go do that? And of course the answer is yes. Like, but thinking of it like that has kind of like switched some things around for me, where I'm like, ooh, I had a conversation with somebody like a couple weeks ago that I didn't think was gonna make me sad, but that did.
Mm-hmm.
And I felt in that moment so appreciative of feeling sad.
Wow.
Just like that in itself, I was like, oh, I haven't been really sad in a while. Like, this is it's nice to feel it.
Yeah.
Whatever it is. So I'm kind of like feelings worth living for. I don't know. Like aren't it's almost like we're almost what there's almost a flip there somewhere, like where it's like, are we living for the feelings almost? You know what I mean? Like, are we not here to just like experience every single thing? And I think like approaching different feelings like that make them, I don't know, like all pretty wonderful.
Mm, yeah, yeah, totally.
So that's kind of what instantly happens in my brain. Yeah. Like, I don't know really a specific feeling. Like, I love the feeling of like the sun in the morning, and I love the feeling of watering my plants, and I love the feeling of creating music. But I'm kind of like, I also really loved being sad that moment. You know what I mean? So I think the answer is all the feelings. If I'm in a place where I can actually really appreciate the feeling, I want to feel it all.
Yeah. Wow. Beautiful answer. Yeah. That was a beautiful answer. Because like it says to me,
a long drawn one.
No, it says,
I was like, there's truth in here somewhere. But like, let me see if I can find it.
Because it says to me. Ooh, is it? It says to me like, that's you practicing gratitude constantly.
Yes.
You know.
Yes. And,
you know.
100%. I think that's the benefit of gratitude for sure. Where you're just like, all right, now, like, all of a sudden, everything is I don't know, pretend, almost like pretending, living in pretend. I'm fishing at this point. But pretending that you're grateful for something will usually make it better.
Yeah.
Even if you don't feel grateful in the moment. So just practicing it, like practicing, like always going to gratitude, like just makes shit better.
I totally agree and identify with what you said. I love the blip of energy. You want to go to Earth for a little hang?
Yep.
That's
just a moment.
That's what we.
It's gonna be great.
Yeah.
You'll come right back to figure out some other fun stuff to do, but like, just go check out all these feelings. It's crazy.
it's like Soul. I watched the movie Soul for the second time the other week. It's just like, yes.
Exactly.
Exactly.
Oh, and what a movie. I've been deep in like my like Pixar like pocket like recently. Disney in general, I'm a big fan.
They're all deep. They're all deep as fuck.
Oh man. 100%. They very little left for randomness in those movies. Mm-hmm. Like it's all
means something.
All pretty profound if you look at it.
Mm-hmm.
Well, sick.
Thank you so much, man. And thank you again. Thanks for contributing your art to this song.
Oh, dude.
It's been super meaningful for me.
No, man. Thank you. Thank you for letting me be a part of this thing. Like this, like I said, like you, this would have been exactly as magical of a song if I had absolutely nothing to do with it.
Oh, no. So I'm just like, hey. I disagree. I think you brought some really beautiful shit to it.
I appreciate that, but definitely like you brought this to me, and like this was already amazing way before I had anything to do with it. So thank you so much for including me in it. I'm very proud to be a part of it.
I'm very humbled by that. Thank you.
My guy.
All right. Bye, bro. Have a beautiful day. I need to wee, but I'll see you the next time we see each other. When I'm next in LA, let's catch up.
Yes. Please hit me up whenever you're here. I would love to kick it and make some music.
That sounds beautiful. Sounds awesome, man.
Amazing.
All right.
All right, man. Have a great day.
Much love, man. See you soon. Bye.